Hello everyone, I hope all of you are good, safe and healthy and working efficiently in your summer internship. Whatever task allocated by the company official, I hope all of you are doing it diligently. Now, I'll make this video a little bit quick. This video is all about report writing while doing work with the company. As you know, this is your 100 marks subject, right? So when your Viva will be conducted, you in the month of August, you need to present one report also. There are other documents also which you need to present, but one of the major document is report writing. First, you are required to write down the report. So if you start writing the report now, right, you have ample time to complete it in an effective and efficient manner, right? Where are the details related to report, how to make the report, how to write down the reference, any sample file, all that is uploaded on this Google Drive link, right? This Google Drive link is given under the description of this video. Once you click on this Google Drive link, this kind of folder will open. There are many ready reckoners I have quoted in this folder for your reference. The four most important one is this training, summer training handbook 2022. Once you open this training handbook, some details are there, which summer internship you are doing and all that. Two points, though I have clarified this previously also, but I just want to throw some again light on that. If there are two ways only that your summer internship can be arranged, either it has been arranged through university or you have arranged by self-arrangement. In case of if the summer internship is arranged through university, no approval was required. Only if the result is updated on the placement portal, I will fetch the data from that and I will share with the examination department that this student is doing the internship in this company. Okay. Second is self-arranged company. If you have found out the company by yourself for doing the summer internship, for that mandatory approval is required. Let's say if you are doing summer internship in a company for which you have not taken the approval, that will not be evaluated by the examination department, because examination department will ask from us that where the student is doing the internship, if that student has not taken the approval, we will not be able to give the details about that. So I hope all of you have taken the approval of your self-arrangement company. If you have not taken, the links and already everything is already given over here. You can see to it and take the approval ASAP. When your Viva will be conducted in the month of August, right? The exact dates will be intimated, informed by the examination department, right? It will be 100 marks Viva, right? You are required to bring out four major things during your Viva, right? First and the foremost important is summer internship report, right? First, you are required to write down this summer internship report. The report related guidelines are given in this handbook only. Second thing you are required to bring out is summer internship completion certificate, which shows that you have worked in this company on whichever role you have chosen, that this so and so student has worked in this company for this 45 days in our company and his performance was good and or very excellent or whatever given by the company. So second thing. Third, you have to make one PPT for your Viva, like another presentation exams where Viva is scheduled, you need to make the PPT. So you are required to prepare the PPT, which includes everything, which I will talk about again later on also. Fourth point, very important, industry feedback form and attendance. See, it is not like that you joined the industry and company and you have worked for one day only, right? So we want your feedback and attendance from the company, for which the form is given at the end of this report. This is the form, your name of the student, registration number, you will provide this to your company official, name of the organization and address, right? They will give you, the industry mentor will give you the marks out of these 100, 10 out punctuality, approach, field work, right? Number of days you were present, right? Number of working days, right? And you know, what are your prospects if you know they would be ready to hire you after completion of your summer internship and any specific observation. On both of these pages, these company stamp and the signature of the company official is required on both of these pages, right? So they will seal this into one envelope and give it to you once it is completed. So for now, these four major important things are you are required to bring during your Viva. If any additional document is required, I will be informing you beforehand, right? Now, how to prepare the report? Everything diligently has been written in this handbook. If you read out in detail, you will get to know. If you are doing the internship in your marketing, finance, HR department, business analytics, product management, whichever role you are doing the internship in that related to role only, you can make the project report writing. Right? If you are doing a work with the NGO, so you can prepare the report related to the NGO. What are the guidelines? Some of the guidelines are there, line spacing, page format and all that. The important point is that minimum pages, many students ask me, so diligently FC understand that to evaluate a good report, minimum of 50 to 60 pages it should be there, right? So what should report your should contain? It should contain title page, the certificate, internship completion certificate, declaration, acknowledgement, everything. These documents are given in the end of this handbook. Executive summary, the table of content of your report, list of tables, figures, symbols, etc. And the most important part of your report is chapters. Now, which chapter you are required to write down? There are 7 chapters. You can divide your report into it. First chapter should be the introduction of your organization. Let's say I am working in with HDFC. So 5 to 7 to 8 pages, I can write down about the organization, when the organization was incorporated, when their IPO came, what work they do, what is their current scenario. Make sure that the information which you write down, it is in your own language. Plagiarism should not be there. Then the second chapter should be the introduction of the topic or the problem statement. Now, project topic, either your manager can give it to you. Some industries, they give the project that, okay, we are allocating you this project, you do the research on this and submit the report in the end. Or if in maximum of the cases, the industry people will not give you the project. So you think about your project related to your work area and related to your industry. In which company, in which industry you are working and which role you are working. According to that, select your topic and problem statement. On that, write down the introduction, then write down the literature review, write down the research methodology, which how you are going to collect the data, is it primary, secondary, which data method collection, sampling method you are going to use and all that, which test you are going to apply, which software you are going to use and all that. After that, data analysis and interpretation, then 6th chapter would be summary, conclusion, limitation, and last is references, bibliography, as per APA style, right? So your evaluation will be done on 2 major parameters. 60 marks would be for your final internship report and 40 marks is for your Viva. This is a tentative, I have written specifically tentative. Because this was the guideline given by the examination last year and most probably it will remain intact like this, but still I have just precautionary, I have written tentative. So organization and introduction, knowledge, report formatting, content quality. So all in all, on your report you will be evaluated for 60 marks and 40 marks for your PPT presentation which you will give, where it includes everything. The question answer round will be conducted by the Viva examiner. The learning outcomes will be asked, the oral presentation, how well you have worked. During your presentation, you are required to present everything. What you have done, the project report writing, what work you have also, practical work you have done in the industry. So both the things you will be presenting into your PPT and you will be evaluated based upon that. So this is an extra one. The front page is given, a sample front page I have made for you, simple same like front page you can make for your report writing. This is a sample template of the certificate, internship completion certificate, right? So internship completion certificate can be different from different companies. I have just given you one template, so if anyone wants that they can follow it. Otherwise, if your company is giving their own format internship completion certificate, that can be done. So declaration, acknowledgement, and you know this industry feedback and attendance form is given this handbook. Other things which are given in this folder is one sample file is given, right? Some student asked that I have not written the report, so one very good report I have attached for your reference. So you can you know download this report, right? 20 MB it is the file. So introduction, research, methodology, consumer, everything like what is required in a good report they have written. This report is little comprehensive, including many things, right? So you can make your report accordingly. How to write down the references, this file is attached over here. So how to write down the references and all that, there are many software also you know with the help of which you can write down the references. So everything is given over here. Some tentative list of topics are also given. This is just a tentative list of some of the topics related to the marketing area or related to the finance area or the other relevant areas. But still you can search it on Google also, what are the you know current upcoming topics related to the field in which you are doing internship in. So according to that you can choose your internship right topic and start writing and working upon your report, right? Very soon I will be allocating one new form to you which will tell about the topic of your report, which will ask about your topic of your report, your industry manager detail, because we will be calling them and asking about your performance also, and the other relevant details, right? Which final company you are doing, some students are selected in 2-3 companies also, right? So which final company? See, you have to understand one thing. Examination will ask the final company of the student from us, from the school. I have to provide that company list, right? So if student is doing in taken the approval of 3-4 companies, I need to have one final list company. So all these things I will be asking in one comprehensive form very soon. So till then, think about the topic of your report and start working upon your report. Thank you everyone. Take good care of yourself. Take care.